What lies beyond the creation of the mural Ecuador by Oswaldo Huellas, I mean? And more importantly, what type of Ecuador does it depict? During the first half of the 20th century, Ecuador was a distressed and fragmented nation. In the early 1940s, after a war in which Ecuador lost nearly half of its territory to Peru, Ecuador faced major economic and political problems, a profound crisis of identity, and numerous challenges such as continuous political unrest, protests by the indigenous and peasants' populations, a discriminatory society, illiteracy, and economic underdevelopment. Since the mid-1940s, a series of modernizing liberal policies were implemented to address the challenge of building a modern nation, a stable economy, and a cohesive sense of national culture. Hoping to organize and solidify the Ecuadorian nation, President José María Velasco Ibarra first, and then Galo Plaza Lasso, introduced and implemented a series of initiatives from 1944 through 1952. For example, literacy campaigns were begun, participation of indigenous people in the economic market was promoted, and the first national census was conducted in 1950 to establish a better understanding of who were the Ecuadorians. Ironically, in a country with large indigenous and black populations, such as Ecuador, the first census of 1950 did not recognize or measure any racial differences. The state also took interest in the development of cultural policies. One particular initiative in this regard was the commissioning of painter Oswaldo Huellas Amin to create a series of paintings representing the nation. That commission resulted in Huacaiñán, El Camino del Llanto, The Way of Tears, from 1952 to 1953, a set of 103 paintings, and the mural Ecuador. The collection was divided and organized around three ethnic cultural groups: Indians, Mestizos, and Black people. The mural titled Ecuador functions as an aesthetic blender. It assembles these themes through five movable panels that can be arranged in any order and theoretically in any position. Huellas Amin was asked to create a work of art depicting a unified Ecuadorian nation in accordance with the ideology of mestizaje, which is a sort of Latin American version of the myth of the melting pot, and produce a dreamed Ecuador in which races would be erased in favor of unity. Despite the fact that the governmental commission intended this to be a plastic representation of a mestizo nation state, unified above and beyond racial divisions and social conflict, Huacaiñán displays a vision of a fractured nation, divided against itself, afflicted by pain and injustice. Rather than sameness, one could say Huacaiñán emphasized plurality, difference, and conflict. Fragmented bodies, tortured expressions, maladies, injustice, misery. Paintings in Huacaiñán expose the anguish of the Ecuadorian nation, a distressed country populated by multiple monsters. These images narrate the pain and wounds of colonialism and oppression ever present in the history of Ecuador. But above all, what they reveal is the impossibility of erasing race and plurality. Monstrosity in Huacaiñán portrays the turmoil and contradictions of trying to imagine a homogeneous nation by using violent brush strokes and by depicting disquieting human bodies. Huellas Amin's Huacaiñán reminds us that the process of nation formation is anything but harmonious, and that nation itself is a work in progress, a restless series of contradictions and continuous negotiation of differences. Perhaps that is the reason the mural Ecuador is so central to this collection. It physically reenacts this restlessness. The movable mural shows that creating a nation, the Ecuadorian nation, entails countless possible combinations, that the nation deals with difference instead of wholeness, and that contradiction should not be erased or resolved, but embraced as a fundamental component of any country. This is what the innovative exhibit Ecuador Unframed does. Led by Professor Carlos Jauregui of the University of Notre Dame, the installation brings the mural to life through a digital unframing. By using an iOS application created for this installation, we're able to shift and move the panels around and see thousands more possibilities than Huellas Amin ever envisioned when he created the mural. While the artist saw nearly 150 combinations, we're now able to see 30,720 combinations just in a rectangular setting. Art in Motion shows Ecuador, the mural, with all its dynamism, and hopes to start multiple conversations about identity, diversity, politics, social justice, and even mathematics.
Quiero que a mí me entierre como a mis antepasados. Yo quiero que a mí me entierre como a mis antepasados. En el vientre oscuro y preso.